Nirvisesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Deshatarine Vancha Kaupata Rubhyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhayevata Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo Namaha Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare 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 Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. We're going over the sixth canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, and we're hearing the pastime of the Narayan Kavacha as given by the Guru of the Demigods. Bishwarup was the guru of the demigods, and he gave them this Narayana Kavacha, which would help them to defeat the demons in battle.
半神人的灵性导师，他叫维舍鲁帕，他给了半神人Narayana Kavacha这个盾，希望用这个盾去打败这些恶魔们。
So this is the prayers which are offered in the Narayana Kavacha. We're just going through them, and there's just a few more. There's one here. Vishwarup says that Prahlad Maharaj loudly chanted the holy name of Lord Nrisimhadev.
我们现在正在了解的就是Narayana Kavacha这个里面的祷文。 Vishwarupa说到 Prahlad Maharaj 高声地唱诵的主 Nrisimhadeva的圣名。
So he says, Lord Nrisimhadev is roaring for his devotee Prahlad Maharaj.
主 Nrisimhadeva 准备保护着他的奉献者 Prahlad Maharaj。
And may Lord Nrisimhadev protect us from all fear and danger.
愿主 Nrisimhadeva 也能保护我们免于一切的危险恐惧。
Danger which may come from poison weapons.
这些危险可能是来自于毒药武器。
Or water or fire.
或者水火。
Air and so many other things.
空气等等其他制造出来的。
May Lord Nrisimhadev cover their influence.
愿主 Nrisimhadeva 能够覆盖这些影响。
So may Lord Nrisimhadev protect us in all directions.
愿主 Nrisimhadeva 在所有的方面都保护我们。
Above, below, within, without, everywhere.
无论是在上面还是在下面，在里面，在外面，都保护我们。
So Vishwarup tells Indra, this mystic armor is related to Lord Narayan.
Vishwarupa 告诉这个Indra说, Indra, 这个Narayana是Kavacha是和这个物品，这个盔甲是和主Narayana有一些玄秘的关系。
And if you cover yourself with this armor, then certainly you'll be able to defeat the demons.
如果你能穿上这件外套, 你肯定能够征服这些恶魔。
And whoever uses this armor, if one uses this armor, whoever he sees with his eyes or touches with his feet is freed from all the dangers.
假如一个人用的这个盔甲，无论他是用双眼看见谁，或是用双足碰到谁， 他都能立即免于所有上述的这些危险。
So this prayer, the Narayana Kavacha, is subtle knowledge.
这个有关于与 Narayana Kavacha 有关的，哦，这个 Narayana Kavacha 是一个很精微的知识。
And if you use this prayer, you'll never be put into danger.
如果一个人用这个祷文，他永远不会被处于危险之中。
You will not get any danger from the government.
他会免于政府的打扰。
You won't get any danger from thieves or demons.
他会免于劫犯或者邪恶之徒的危险的这些打扰。
And you don't have to fear any type of disease.
而且你也不用担心任何的危险的疾病。
So this is the power of the Narayana Kavacha.
这就是 Narayana Kavacha 盾的力量。
So then Vishwarupa tells about the history of this mantra. He says, in the past, there was a Brahmana named Kaushik.
现在 Vishwarupa 将会讲述 Narayana Kavacha 的一个有关他的历史。有一个婆罗门叫 Kaushik.
So he purposely gave up his body in the desert by mystic power.
他有意的在沙漠的地方用玄秘力量放弃他的躯体。
So it happened that after that Kaushika gave up his body, then the king of the Gandharvas, a person called Chitrarata, was passing in his aeroplane.
当这个国王放弃了躯体之后，在这个沙漠里，有一个甘达尔瓦洛卡的一个国王刚好路过这里。
So this king was named Chitrarata, and he was surrounded by many beautiful women, and they were with him in the aeroplane.
国王的名字叫 Chitrarata, 他被很多美女所簇拥着，他们坐在一架飞机上路过这里。
And their airplane came over the place where the Brahmana's body was.
而且这个飞机刚好飞越了那位 Brahmana 的躯体所在的上空。
And they passed the exact spot where the Brahmana had given up his body.
这架飞机刚好飞越了那位 Brahmana 的躯体。
So suddenly, that king of the Gandharvas, he fell.He was forced to fall from the sky head first with his aeroplane.
突然，这个齐彻拉塔就是这个国王，连同飞机被迫的头朝下，从空中坠落下来。
And then he was ordered by the great sages to throw the Brahmana's bones in the nearby river Saraswati.
于是有一位伟大的圣人，他就命令这个国王说，你得把这个婆罗门的骨头扔到圣河萨拉萨提河里面。
And he had to do this before, after he threw the bones in the river, then he had to bathe in the river to purify himself because he'd been touching the bones of a dead body. So then he had to bathe in the river to purify himself.
当这个国王把这个婆罗门的骨头扔到萨尔萨提河之后，他然后就在河中沐浴，因为他触碰了这个死人的骨头，所以他得在河中沐浴来净化他自己。
And only then he could return to his residence, to his own abode.
只有在做了这个事情之后，他才能够返回自己的居所。
So Sukadeva Goswami is telling Maharaj Parikshit about this.
Sukadeva Goswami 给 Maharaj Parikshit 讲述了这个事情。
And he tells Maharaj Parikshit, if you use this armor, or if you hear about it with faith and proper respect, so if you're ever afraid of any condition in the material world, you'll be free from all the danger.
Shukadeva Goswami 跟 Maharaj Parikshit 讲，使用这件武器，或者说以信心和恰当的尊敬之心去聆听他的人，将会在这个物质世界感到任何情况下感到恐惧的时候，都会立即免于所有的危险。
So King Indra had performed 100 sacrifices.
Indra 做了100次的祭祀。
So he got this prayer of protection from Vishwarupa.
他从 Vishwarupa 那里得到了这个有关保护的祷文，祈祷文。
So after he conquered the demons, he enjoyed all the opulences of the three worlds.
当他征服了恶魔之后，他享受了三个世界的全部富裕。
So you can see the effect of the armor. The Vishwarupa gave this armor to Indra, and it was so powerful that Indra was able to defeat the demons.
我们可以知道 Vishwarupa 给予 Indra 的这个玄秘力量的盔甲是非常有力量的，他甚至能够征服恶魔们。
And Indra was able to get back the heavenly planets and enjoy the opulence of the three worlds.
Indra 就可以回归到天堂星宿，然后享受着三个世界的富裕。
Three worlds mean Bhuloka, Bhuvarloka, and Swarga.Loka, the heavenly planets.
三个世界是指的 Bhuloka, Bhuvarloka, Swargaloka, 三个世界，包括天堂星宿的三个世界的这些富裕。
So we should understand, we have to receive the mantras from a bona fide spiritual master, otherwise the mantras will not be effective.
这里面还有一个需要理解的是，我们必须得从一位真正的灵性老师，你灵性导师那里去接受这些曼陀罗，否则这个曼陀罗不会有效果。
It is said, Sampradaya Vihina Yemantraste Nishfala Mata, that if you receive the mantra which is not in the disciplic succession, then it will not have any effect.
如果一个人不是从师徒传承那里去接受任何一个曼陀罗的话，那么接受这样一个曼陀罗的话，那么这个曼陀罗不会有任何的效果。
And also in the Bhagavad Gita, Lord Krishna says, if you want to learn the truth, you have to approach a spiritual teacher.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》中也说到，如果你想去接近绝对真理，你必须去寻找一位灵性导师。
So all the mantras have to be received through the authorized spiritual teachers.
因此，所有的曼陀罗都必须从确定的权威那里，权威的灵性导师那里去接受。
And the process of receiving the mantra is that first you have to satisfy the spiritual teacher.
而得到这个曼陀罗的这个程序，是你必须去满足。让你的灵性导师得到满意。
In the fourth chapter, verse 34, Lord Krishna describes the process of approaching the spiritual teacher.
主 Krishna 在《薄伽梵歌》4.34中讲了去接近灵性导师的这个程序。
First, you have to surrender, tadvidi pranipatena. You have to fall down in front of the spiritual teacher.
首先你就得臣服，你得完全的拜倒在你的灵性导师之下，去臣服于他。
Then you have to put proper inquiries before him.
之后你得去恰当的向他询问。
And then you should render service to him.
再之后我们得向他做一些服务。
So this is aprocess of approaching the spiritual teacher.
这就是接近一位灵性导师的程序。
So if we want to advance, we have to receive the mantras from one of the sampradayas.
如果我们想要进步，我们得从一个师徒传承那里去接受这个曼陀。
Right, there are four sampradayas. There's a Brahma sampradaya, Rudra sampradaya,Kumar Sampradaya and Sri or Lakshmi Sampradaya.
有四条师徒传承，第一个是 Brahma 师徒传承 ，Rudra 师徒传承 Sampradaya， 诗意就是幸运女神的师徒传承 ，Kumar 四库马尔就 Kumar 师徒传承。
Right, the main acharya in the Kumar Sampradaya is Nimbarka.
Kumar Sampradaya 师徒传承的一个主要的 acharya 灵性导师是 Nimbarka.
Right, and then in the Sri Sampradaya, the main acharya is Ramanuja.
Sri Sampradaya 的一个主要的灵性导师是 Ramanuja.
And then the Rudra Sampradaya, the main acharya is Vishnu Swami.
Rudra Sampradaya 的一位主要的 acharya 是 Vishnu Swami.
And in the Brahma Sampradaya, we have Madhvacharya.
在 Brahma Sampradaya, 我们有的这位灵性导师 acharya 是 Madhva Acharya.
So Lord Chaitanya took initiation in the line from Brahma, which is the Madhva Sampradaya, coming through Madhva.
主 Chaitanya 是也是从 Brahma Sampradaya, 他也是来自于 Madhva Acharya 这一条师徒传系之中的。
So all these four Sampradayas, they all agree that the living entity is the servant of the Supreme Lord.
所有的这四条师徒传承，他们都接受所有的生物体只是至尊主的仆人。
Okay, so we'll go ahead now. We'll go on to chapter 9, describing the appearance of Vishwarup.
我们现在进入到第九章的学习，了解 Vishwarupa 的显现。
Oh, no, not Vishwarupa,
Vritasura.
Vritasura, right.Vishwarupa is the guru and Vritasura is the demon.
Vishwarupa is the 半神的灵性导师之前的半神灵性导师，而 Vritasura 是一位恶魔。
But Vritasura is also a great devotee.
Vritasura 也是一位伟大的奉献者。
But he's just in the body of a demon.
但是他的躯体是一个恶魔。
So we hear about it in this chapter.
我们将会在这一章中聆听到这一切。
So Vishwarupa was a priest of the demigods, and he had three heads.
Vishwarupa, 他是半神的灵性导师，半神的祭师，他有三颗头颅。
With one head, he used to drink somaras.
他用一颗头去喝饮 somarasa 的饮料。
And another head, he used to drink wine.
另外一颗头去喝酒。
And with the third head, he would eat food.
他用第三颗头去吃食物。
So we have to understand that we cannot directly understand the heavenly planets.
我们无法直接的去感知天堂星球。
And we cannot.Fully understand all these inhabitants who live there in the higher planets.
我们也无法确切地理解他们那里天堂星球这些高等星球他们那些居民的生活习惯。
We cannot go to the heavenly planets in this body.
我们无法用我们现有的躯体去到那个星球。
The material scientists, they are trying to invent spaceships to go to higher planets, but this is not possible.
物质主义科学家他们企图造这些太空飞船去到那些星球，但是这是不可能的。
But if we want to know about these places, we can hear about them from the authorities.
但是如果你又想知道这些事情的话，我们得从经典权威，我们得从权威那里去聆听。
So here, Sukadeva Goswami says that I'm telling you what I have heard from authoritative sources.
现在 Sukadeva Goswami 说，我现在所向你描述的都是我从权威那里聆听所得到的。
So this is the Vedic system.
这就是伟达的系统制度。
The Vedic knowledge is called Shruti, which means the hearing process.
伟达的知识又叫做 Shruti, 意味着这是聆听的程序。
So, on the basis of these scriptures, we are hearing about different inhabitants on the higher planets.
通过从权威那里聆听，我们知道这些不同的星球的他们的不同的习惯。
Just like if we want to understand who is our father, the best way is to hear from the mother.
就像如果我们想知道谁是我们的父亲，那么我们就得从我们的母亲那里去聆听。
If you go to so many men and ask them, "Are you my father? Are you my father?" We may never find our father.
如果我们去找一些男的，就随便就去问他们，你是我的父亲吗？你是我的父亲吗？我们可能永远都找不到我们的父亲。
So that is the ascending process. It's very troublesome to try to understand the absolute truth by the ascending process, which means by our own efforts.
这个是属于通过个人努力或者经验去得到的，通过个人努力去找到的这种知识。
But if we take the help of the authorities, then very quickly we can solve the problem.
但如果我们能够从权威那里去获得帮助的话，我们能够很快的去解决我们的问题。
So if we want to know who's the father, we have to ask the mother.
因此，如果我们想知道谁到底是我们的父亲，那我们就去问我们的母亲就好了。
If we want to know about the supreme absolute truth, we have to ask from the Vedas. Look in the Vedas, and we'll find out.
如果我们想知道到底谁是至尊的绝对真理，那么我们就去找《伟达经》就行。
So Maharaj Parikshit is hearing about this, how the demigods were taking help from Vishwarup.
Maharaj Parikshit 就聆听到的半神人是如何获得了 Vishwarupa 的帮助的。
So Vishwarup, from his father's side, they were related to the demigods.
Vishwarupa 的父亲他是与半神人相连的。
So when he would make offerings, he would offer the ghee in the fire, chanting mantras like Indraya Idam Swaha, meaning he's offering this for King Indra.
因此他向这个火中供奉酥油的时候，他会唱 Indraya Idam Swaha, 这就是意味着这是给 Indra 王的。
And then you chant Idam Agnaye, this is for the demigod of the fire, Agni.
当他唱诵 Idam Agnaye, 就是说这是给火神 Agni 的。
So in this way he would offer to each of the demigods different oblations of ghee in the fire.
就以这样的方式，他向半神人供奉不同的物品，通过火。
But without the knowledge of the demigods, he would also offer to the demons.
虽然他也向半神人供奉，但是他也偷偷地向恶魔在供奉。
Because his mother was related to the demons, so he felt some affection for the demons also.
因为他的母亲和恶魔也有关联，所以他也跟恶魔有一些特殊的感情。
So he had the feelings for both the demigods and for the demons.
他对半神人和恶魔两方都有一些感情。
And so he would make offerings to the Supreme Lord on behalf of the demons and also on behalf of the demigods.
他既代表着半神人向至尊主供奉，也代表着恶魔向主供奉。
But he would do the offering on behalf of the demons secretly, without the demigods knowing.
但是他当他代表着恶魔去向火中供奉的时候，他是很秘密的做，没有让半世人知道。
However, what it happened that Indra he understood what Vishwaroop was doing.
但是然而有一次 ，Indra 就知道他到底在做什么了。
He understood Vishwaroopa was cheating the demigods.
他知道 Vishwaroopa 在欺骗半神。
He was offering oblations on behalf of the demons.
他代表着这些恶魔在供奉祭品。
So when Indra understood that, then he became very afraid of being defeated again by the demons.
当 Indra 知道了这一事情之后，他非常害怕再一次被这些恶魔所打败。
So Indra cut off the three heads of Vishwaroop.
所以 Indra 就砍掉了 Vishwaroopa 头上的三颗头。
Now Vishwaroopa was a Brahmin and he was a guru.
但是 Vishwaroopa 是一个婆罗门，而且他是半神的灵性导师。
Anyway, the head which he cut off, which was drinking the somaras, that became a Franklin partridge.
后来，这个喝以索玛月露的头变成了一只鹌鹑。
A type of bird.
反就是一种鸟。
And then the head which was meant for drinking wine.That became a sparrow.
而喝酒的那个头就变成了一只麻雀。
And the head which was for eating food, that became a common partridge.
用来吃食物的那只头也变成了一只普通的鹌鹑。
So one head had become a sparrow, one head had become a common partridge.And the other head had become a Franklin partridge.
一只头变成了这个孤鹫，另外一只变成了麻雀，而最还有一只头变成了这个鹌鹑。
So Indra had to he accepted the sinful reactions for killing their guru.
Indra 他接受了他杀害他的灵性导师的这一罪恶反应。
Now Indra was very powerful. He could have neutralized the sinful reactions.
Indra 是非常有力量的，他能够抵消杀死一位婆罗门的罪恶反应。
But instead he accepted the burden of these reactions.
但是他双手合十，还是接受了这些反应。
And he felt guilty, he felt sorry that he'd done it.
而且他非常忏悔、懊悔，感觉到非常忏悔的做了这样的事情。
So that's because he knew he'd done wrong, so he thought I should suffer for it, it's not proper.
他知道的他做错了，他而且他也觉得他应该承受一定的罪，承受一定的反应。
So he suffered, it said Indra suffered for 1 year.
他遭受了一年的痛苦。
And then, after 1 year, to purify himself, he distributed the reactions for his sinful killing among the earth and the water and the trees and women.
随后为了净化自己，他将这个罪恶、罪反反应的这个罪恶、杀戮的行为的罪恶反应分派给了大地。水、树木和女人。
Yeah, because in the past, he'd taken benedictions from them. In the past, he'd given them benedictions. So now he's sharing his sinful reactions to them.
因为在过去 ，Indra 给予了土地、大土地、水啊，他们一些好处，所以这个时候他可以把这些罪恶就分派给他们。
So we'll hear more about this.
我们将聆听到有关这个里面的更多细节。
So because Indra gave a benediction to the earth. that the earth would be automatically filled up. That, you know, if you make a hole, if you dig a ditch in the earth, then after some time the dirt will all fill up and that the ditch will become full again.
因着给了土地的这个恩惠，就是说，当我们把土地给砍出一条沟壑的时候，过一段时间，这个沟会自动的填平，所以这个是土地所受到的恩惠。So,
because Indra gave that benediction to the earth, so he gave the earth 1/4 of his sinful reactions.
因为因着给予了土地这样的一个祝福，土地也接受了因着。
So the sinful reactions which came on the earth was that we find deserts on the surface of the earth.
这样的一个罪恶反应到地球的土地的表面上时，我们会发现地球的表面上有一部分沙漠。
So when we see a desert on the earth, we should understand this is the disease condition of the planet.
当我们看到沙漠的时候，我们知道这个是地球表面的土地的一种病态的展示。And
no auspicious ritualistic ceremonies are supposed to be performed in a desert.
因为在沙漠中无法举行吉祥的祭祀仪式。
And people who live in the desert, they're also sharing the reactions for the sin of killing a brahmana.
而居在沙漠中的人也可以被理解为那些他们正在分享着杀害婆罗门的这个罪恶的反应。All
right, and then the trees also got reactions.
树木也得到了反应.
Because Indra had given a benediction to the trees that when their branches and twigs would be cut, they could grow back again.
树木得到Indra的恩惠是当这个树木的树枝被剪断之后，它能够再次生长出来，这就是树木得到的Indra的恩惠。
So the trees also took 1/4 of the reaction for killing a brahmana.
所以树木也承担因转四分之一的杀害婆罗门罪恶反应.
And the reaction in the trees is seen in the flowing of sap which comes from the trees.
从树它接受的这个罪恶反应之后， 有一些树木，我们可以看到它会流一些液体出来。
And we're not, nobody should drink this sap.
这样的液体不应该被人们喝，就是人们应禁止喝这些树叶。
And then women also had to take some reaction, share of the reactions for Indra killing the brahmana.
就是女性也
Because Indra had given a benediction to women that they could enjoy lusty desires even during pregnancy.
因为女性曾经也得到Indra的这个祝福或者说恩惠，就是她们能够甚至在怀孕期间还能够享受色欲。
As long as the sex is not going to cause any injury to the embryo, then the woman can have sex.
只要不伤害到胎儿，这个女性都可以一直享受色欲。
So this was Indra's benediction to women.
这是Indra给予女性的祝福。
So the reaction which they had to take was that women, they have to go through menstruation every month.
而女性接受这个Indra承担的这个罪恶反应就是她每个月会有月经。
So we know for women, generally women are quite lusty and it's difficult for them to control their material desires.
女性作为一个阶层，她们通常有很强的色欲，而且很难控制这种欲望。
Often they're never satisfied, even though they may be pregnant, still they want to have sex.
通常她们无法得到满足，即便她们有了怀孕的，但是她们仍然有着色欲。
So in return for Indra's benediction that they could have sex even when they're pregnant, women suffer this menstruation cycle.
为了回报 Indra 给予女人这种永无止境色欲的祝福，他们接受了杀害一位婆罗门的罪恶反应的四分之一。
So this is their sinful reaction for killing the Brahman. This is their share.Of the sinful reaction for killing a Brahmana.
这就是他们接受 Indra 杀害婆罗门的四分之一分享承担的这个罪恶反应。
And then the fourth party to share the reactions, because there was the earth, the trees, women.And now finally water. Water also got a benediction from Indra.
总共有四个种类，他们分担 Indra 的罪恶反应。前面我们提到土地、树木还有女性，现在最后一个是水。
So water got the benediction that it would increase the volume of any other substance when it's mixed with it.
水得到的 Indra 的祝福是它能够增加与之相混的其他物质的体积的这个祝福。
Just like you can mix water with, you can mix water with wine, or you can mix water with milk, and you can mix water, you can put it in maybe potatoes, maybe you're doing mashed potato sabji, you can put water in there, and it will mix with it. You don't notice it.
就像我们去把水、牛奶、果汁包括西红柿混合在一起，我们在做这个 subji 的时候在里面加水，但是呢我们甚至有可能感觉不到没有意识到这一点。
So the water, the reaction which came on water was that there would be bubbles and foam in water.
这个罪恶反应到水这儿来，就是水中会有气泡或泡沫。
And when you collect water, then you shouldn't take water which has got bubbles and foam in it.
当我们去收集采集水的时候，应该去避免这些水泡气，避免这些气泡泡沫。
So this was the reaction which came on water.
这就是给予水它所承担的罪恶反应。
So, just like when you mix water with these things, you cannot always understand it has water in it. Just like you buy milk, you don't know if there's water in it or not. They can add the water into it, and you can't tell.
这个水与牛奶、果汁或其他物质相混的时候会增加体积。有时候我们去买一杯牛奶，但是我们不知道到底这个牛奶里面是否被掺水了。
Anyway, if we see foam and bubbles in the water, then you want to avoid that water.
不管怎么样，当我们看到水中如果有气泡或泡沫的时候，我们不要这种水。
That's not for drinking anyway.
这样的水不是用来饮用的。
So after Indra had killed Vishwarup, then Vishwarup's father was very upset.
当 Indra 杀了 Vishwarupa 时候，他的父就是这个 Vishwarupa 的父亲，非常的悲伤。
His father was a great sage. His name was Twasta.
他的父亲也是一位伟大的圣人，他的名字叫 Twasta.
So he did a ceremony, and he wanted to get somebody to kill Indra.
他想做一个祭祀仪式来得到一个人去杀了鹰准。
So he did a fire sacrifice, and he was chanting into the fire that he was saying, O enemy of Indra, flourish to kill your enemy without delay.
他于是做了一个火祭，这个他在做这个火祭的时候就说到，鹰准的敌人啊，毫无延迟的去杀掉你的敌人。
So when he was chanting the mantra, Tvasta made a mistake in the mantra chanting.
当阿斯塔在唱诵这个曼陀罗的时候，他在唱诵的过程中出了一点点错误。
One of the characters, one of the syllables was to be a long sound, and he made it a short sound.
有一个音节本来应该是长音的，他唱成了短音。
So it changed the meaning.
于是就改变了曼陀罗的意义。
So he chanted the word Indra Shatro, which means O enemy of Indra.
他本来是要唱 Indra Satro， 这个意思是 Indra 的敌人啊。
So Indra is in the positive case.
Indra 是处在一个
positive case. It's grammar. It's a particular.Type of grammar.
Okay, Indra 是属在所有格之上。
Oh, Indra is a possessive case, not positive. Possessive case.
嗯 ，Indra 是所处在所有格之上，就是一个语法上的说法。
嗯 ，And the word Indra Shatro is a special kind of it's a combination, it's a compound word, has, you know, to mean two words put together.
Indra Shatro 是一个复合词。
But he was supposed to chant the mantra short, but instead he chanted it long.
他本来应该是唱短音的。
So the meaning changed.
所以这个意义就改变了。
And it changed from the enemy of Indra, it became Indra who is an enemy.
所以变成了 Indra, 他是一位敌人。原本的本应该是 Indra 的敌人变成了 Indra, 他是一位敌人。
So he wanted somebody who was an enemy of Indra, but instead, from the body,came a demon of whom Indra was the enemy.
就是结果是威彻苏热的身体出现的不是 Indra, 是 Indra 的一位敌人，而是 Indra 他是他的敌人。
So, you see, chanting mantras is a very complex subject. You have to be very careful.
所以从这里了解到，唱诵曼陀罗是一个非常复杂的，工作，应该非常非常的小心。
So, from the south side of the sacrificial fire came a very fearful personality.
于是从祭火的南边出现了一位非常恐惧的人物。
He looked like somebody who could destroy the entire creation.
他看上去就像年代之末的整个创造的毁灭者。
Just like at the end of the millennium, somebody comes to destroy the creation.
就像在整个年代之末会出现一个毁灭者。
So this demon was just incredibly...terrifying for everyone.
所以就在祭火的南边出现了一位非常恐惧，令人感觉到害怕恐惧的人物。
The demon's body grew every day, day after day, grew bigger and bigger.
这个恶魔的身体一天一天的长大。
He was very big and blackish color. And he was like, it was like having clouds in the sky in the evening.
And
the hair on the demon's head and his body and his beard, it was the color of copper. In other words, it was like red color. His beard, his mustache, and the hair on his body, it was all this copper color. And he had these piercing eyes. And just looking at him, nobody could imagine they could ever defeat him in battle.
只是看他一眼, 就觉得这个人是无法取胜的一个人。
He appeared to like he was holding the three worlds on his trident. He was carrying a trident. It was like he had the three worlds on the points of the trident.
他有一个三叉戟, 他的三叉戟间好像在支撑着整个三世界一样。
So he was dancing and shouting loudly.
他又唱歌又 他又大声地嚷嚷又跳着舞,
and all the earth began to tremble just like there was an earthquake.
整个地球的表面都在颤抖, 好像要发生地震一样。
And when he would yawn, it was like he was going to swallow the whole sky with his mouth.
当他打哈欠的时候, 似乎要吞下整个天。
His mouth was like a big cave.
他的口就像山洞一样,
and it was like he was going to lick up all the stars in the sky with his tongue.
他想要用舌头好像去舔天上的所有的这些星星,
and eat the universe with his long sharp teeth.
然后用他的尖尖长长的牙齿去吃掉整个宇宙。
So when everybody saw this demon, it was so gigantic and terrifying. Everyone was afraid and they just ran in any direction just to get away.
任何一个目睹这个庞大恶魔的人, 他们都惊恐万分, 四处逃散。
So this demon was actually the son of Tvasta.
这个恶魔事实上是Tvasta的儿子。
Covered all the planetary systems.
覆盖了所有的星系。
So he was called Vrita, which means one who covers everything.
所以他的名字叫Vritra, 就是说覆盖一切的人。
Because the demon covered all the planetary systems, so his name was Vritasura.
因为这个恶魔覆盖所有的星系, 所以他的名字叫Vritasura.
So when the demigods saw him, so headed by Indra, they charged with all their soldiers.
以Indra为首的半神人和所有的这些士兵们就准备进攻这个恶魔。
And they attacked him and they hit him with all their weapons, all their arrows and all their other weapons.
他们用超然的弓箭和所有的这各种各样的武器去攻击这个恶魔。
But Vritasura just swallowed all their weapons.
但是Vritasura吃掉了他们所有的武器。
So when the demigods saw that, they were really disappointed.
当半世人们看到这一切，他们非常的失望。
And the demigods lost their own strength. They had no more enthusiasm to fight.
半世人失掉了，就是丧失了自己的力量，没有办法去作战。
So they all met together and they tried to please the super soul.
于是他们就聚集在一起，想去取悦至尊超灵。
They worship Lord Narayan.
他们就开始崇拜主 Narayan.
And the demigods offered prayers to Lord Narayan.
半神人就开始向主 Narayan 供奉祈祷文。
They say to Lord Narayan, the three worlds are created by the five elements.
半神人们说，三个世界被五种元素创造。
Five elements: earth, water, fire, air, ether.
以太、空气、水、火、土。
So these worlds are controlled by demigods, beginning from Lord Brahma.
这个世界被以主 Brahma 为开始的各位半神所控制着。
So, demigods are always afraid of the time factor, that the time factor will destroy everything.
半神们总是害怕着时间的因素的存在。
So we always offer our presentations to time.
所以我们以我们总是向时间供奉礼物。
The time factor actually is Krishna himself.
时间因素事实上就是 Krishna 人。
Well, anyways, Krishna is the time factor is actually afraid of Krishna.
事实上，时间因素本身却害怕至尊人格守神。
In the Bhagavad Gita, we read that Krishna is time. Krishna says, "Time I am, destroyer of the world."
主 Krishna 在博迦梵歌中说，我是时间，毁灭整个一切。
But here in the demigods' prayers, they say the time factor is afraid of Krishna.
在圣殿博迦瓦坛，现在我们看到是半神在供奉祷文的这个过程中也写到。半世人就是时间因素本身却害怕至尊人格。
So the demigods say we want to worship the Supreme Lord who can give us full protection.
因此半世人继续说，现在让我们崇拜那位至尊主，那位可以给予我们全然保护的那位至尊主。
When we're afraid of being killed, we have to take shelter of Krishna.
当一个人害怕被杀死的时候，他必须去托庇尊主 Krishna。
Krishna is worshipped by all the demigods, beginning from Brahma.
主 Krishna 被以被所有之人所崇拜，半神的以 Brahma 为首的所有的半神人所崇拜。
And even the demons, they're afraid of Krishna.
即便这些恶魔们，他们都害怕 Krishna.
The demigods are afraid of death, so they take shelter of Krishna.And offered prayers to him.
这些半神人他非常害怕死亡，所以他们托庇于主 Krishna.
Fear personified is afraid of Krishna.
恶就是恐惧的人格化身，甚至都害怕 Krishna.
So Krishna is called Abhaya, meaning one who has no fear.
所以主 Krishna 也被称为 Abhaya， 就是无畏的，无所惧怕的。
And if we take shelter of Krishna, that brings fearlessness.
因此，如果我们能够托庇于主 Krishna， 就会能够带来真正的无所畏惧。
So the demigods also want to take shelter of Krishna.
所以这些半神也决定托庇于主 Krishna。
Okay, we will stop.
Okay, 我们现在讲到这里。
Are there any questions today?
Yes. First question from Yogita Sharma. Hare Krishna Gurudev, please accept my humble obeisances. Gopis in the Vrindavan plays such a vital role of serving and pleasing the Lord. And he is playing.His pleasure potency is Srimati Radharani, a girl. Do Matajis in the mature world have any benedictions from any sages or demigod or the Lord, which gives them strength and strength for serving or worshiping the Lord that can help them develop more love for desiring to serve the Lord with the determination.
No.
Hare Krishna.
I don't know any.
Then, okay. Good day. Let me translate. Hare Krishna, good day. 请接受我卑微的顶拜。这些牧牛姑娘们在文当文当扮演着一个服务取悦主的这个角色，他们是主的快这个 Sri Mati Rani 主的快乐能量。我想问的就是说，是否 Madhaji 在这个物质世界的这些 Madhaji 们是否得到了这些圣人或者半神或主的祝福，能够让他们在服务或崇拜的服务主或崇拜主的过程中，能够帮助他们发展出越来越多的爱，能够服务主呢？ Hare Krishna.
No, I've never heard any. But in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna says, Striyo Vaishyastata Sudrastepi Yanti Paramgatim. That even though one may be of lower birth, like women, Sudra or Vaishya, still they can attain the supreme destination.
我没有听到说这个女性获得这个圣人的一种特殊的祝福，但是呢，在佛家中主说，即便是这些低等阶层的女，比如说女性 Sudra Vaishya 这样的一些低等阶层，即便是他们也能够得到最，他们如果在服务的过程中也能够得到最大的益处。
Yeah. Any other question?
Okay. Next question from Vidavati. 顶拜 Guru Day, 感恩翻译。我们现在唱诵的祷文有的发音不准，会有什么样的后果呢？感恩 Hare Krishna.Question from Vedavati, obeisance to Guru Dev, and if we chant the prayers and some pronunciation is not correct, so what happened? Thanks, Hare Krishna.
Well, we have to chant the prayers with devotion. That's the main thing.
我们得唱诵的过程中怀着奉爱，这是最主要的事情。
Right, you have to chant the prayers with the feeling of Krishna is concerned with the love which you're offering the prayers. He's not concerned with the pronunciation, but he's looking at the love.
当我们唱诵这些祷文的时候，我们怀着对 Krishna 的奉爱。Krishna 看的是我们，是我们，他 Krishna 关心的是我们在唱诵的过程中到底有多少的奉爱。他关心的不是我们在唱诵中的这个发音的问题。
But this person, Twasta,He was doing a sacrifice. He wanted to create the demon who was going to kill Indra.
我们今天所看到这个 Twasta, 他做这个祭祀，他唱诵这个曼陀罗，是想得到一个恶魔去杀害主因，就是杀害半神 Indra.
So it was a very fruitive activity he was doing. It was not devotion.
所以他做的是。报内心的活动，而不是奉爱的服务。
So when we chant with devotion, we're doing bhakti yoga. You see, that demon who was doing the sacrifice, he was not doing bhakti yoga.
我们做的是奉爱瑜伽的活动，但是这个恶魔
，Actually, he wasn't a demon. He was a great sage.Twasta was a great saint. He wasn't a demon. He was a demigod almost. He was with the demigods.
但是这个 Twasta, 他是一个半神，他做的不是奉爱瑜伽的这个活动。
But Krishna's happy if we chant with devotion.
如果我们 唱诵的过程中是怀着风爱的 ，Krishna 会开心。
There was a Brahmana chanting the Bhagavad Gita. He was reading the Bhagavad Gita, but he couldn't read it very well. All the other Brahmanas were laughing at him.
有一个故事就是讲一个婆罗门，他在读圣读《薄伽梵歌》，但是他并不读得很好，所有人都在取笑他。
But when he was reading the Bhagavad Gita, tears were coming from his eyes.
但他在读《薄伽梵歌》的时候，眼泪就从他的眼睛里流出来。
So Lord Chaitanya asked him, "What are you doing?"
主 Chaitanya 就问他，你在做什么呢？
So he said, "My guru told me to read the Bhagavad Gita every day."
这个婆罗门就说，我的灵性导师告诉我每天都要读《薄伽梵歌》。
Oh Lord Chaitanya said, "It's very good. You follow the order of your guru. Very nice."
主 Chaitanya 就说，你做得非常好，你竟然遵守你 guru 的训示。
But then Lord Chaitanya asked him, said, "Why are you crying? What are the tears for?"
主 Chaitanya 接着又问，你为什么又哭泣呢？你的为何而哭泣呢？
So then the Brahmana said, "Because when I read the Bhagavad Gita, I think how merciful Lord Krishna is, that he became the chariot driver for his devotee Arjuna."
这个婆罗门就说，当我在读《薄伽梵歌》的时候，我为这个 Krishna 的仁慈，我太为他所感动了。这个主 Krishna 竟然成为他奉献者的马车夫。
So Lord Chaitanya said, "Ah, said very, you are the real reader of the Bhagavad Gita."
主 Chaitanya 就说，啊，你是真正的《薄伽梵歌》的阅读者。
Even though he was not well educated and couldn't read well, but Lord Chaitanya said, "You are the real reader of the Bhagavad Gita."
即便他是一个接受教育程度高的人，读的也并不好，但是呢，主柴坦尼亚却说他是一位真正的能够读、真正的阅读者，《薄伽梵歌》的真正的阅读者。
But Lord Chaitanya also taught the Brahmana how to read the Bhagavad Gita.
然后主柴坦尼亚也后来教了他如何去阅读《薄伽梵歌》。
Every day, Lord Chaitanya would come and teach him.
每一天主柴坦尼亚都会来那里去教他教这个婆罗门如何读薄伽梵歌。
So if our pronunciation is not very good, you know, we should try to improve. It takes some time.
因此如果我们觉得我们的发音并不好的话，我们也可以想着，我们也应该想着要去提高，需要一点时间。
But Krishna considers the heart.Of the devotee.
但是 Krishna 考虑的是这个奉献者他内心。
Different parts of the world pronunciation will be different.
这个世界的不同的地方的人，他们的发音都是不一样的。
The Russian devotees, they will say Hare Krishna.
这个俄罗斯的奉献者，他们的这个发音就像咕噜刚刚讲的 Hare Krishna，
Hare Krishna， Krishna。
这俄罗斯发音的这个风格。
And Chinese devotees, we also have our own way to pronounce.
我们中国奉献者
Hare Krishna。
我们中国奉献者也有我们自己的发音特点。
Hare Krishna。
Hare Krishna。
So it's not, you know, our pronunciation is not very accurate. And my pronunciation is also not good. Because I'm not Indian, so I pronounce everything in the Western way.
我的发音也不好，因为我不是一个英国人，我发音都是比较西方的这个情况。
So whenever I say a verse in Sanskrit, the Indians will say, "Oh no, they can't, you know, they can't recognize what I'm saying."
当我去念一个梵文的时候，印度人他们也无法认可我的这个情况。
But we hope Krishna recognizes our heart, our intention.
但不管怎么样，我们希望 Krishna 能够了解我们的内心和意图。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Sitarani Mataji, 顶拜姑的莲花族，感恩诸佛的奉献者。为什么 Indra 为了净化自己而把罪恶分发给大地、树木、水和女人？Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet, I want to ask why the Indra, he intends to, purify himself. He wants to shell the.
Yes.
Shell this reaction to the earth, trees and the water and the women. Why he do this?
Well, he wanted to get rid of it because he'd given benedictions to them. So he thought, let them help me now. I need help from them.
这个 Indra 就是想摆脱这个罪恶反应。他说他觉得因为他以前也帮助了这些给予了他们的祝福，所以他希望现在能够得到大地、树木、女人、水，得到他们帮助。
If you take a loan from someone, you know, if you borrow money from someone, in the future they're going to come, and they're going to want to get money back from you. They want to borrow from you.
如果你以前贷过款找别人借过钱的话，在将来有一天那个人还是会来，他来找你要钱。
You give a favor to someone, you do a favor for someone, in the future, you may want them to do a favor for you.
你现在帮了某人一个忙，你希望将来的某一天，这个人也能够帮帮你。
That is just human nature.
这是人类的本性。
So that nature is there in the demigods also.
Next question.
Yeah.
Next question from Hari Vamsa Prabhu. Po Bi Yu. Hare Krishna.
Hare Bo.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna. Good day. Next question from Hari Vamsa Prabhu. To Bi Yu, 无惧的至尊主还会害怕，还会怕时间的恐惧人格化身，是为什么？为什么时间的人格化身害怕至尊主？脱比于无惧的至尊主还会害怕时间的恐惧的人格化身？时间的恐惧的。If takes the shelter of the Lord Himself, why he's afraid of the time personifying?
If he takes shelter of the Lord, why is he afraid of time personified? No, the point is, time personified is afraid of Krishna.
这个要点是，时间的人格化身害怕主 Krishna. Then he asked why the time personified afraid of Krishna.
Why is it afraid of Krishna?Because Krishna, because Krishna is the supreme power. So if Krishna wants to stop time, he can stop it.
因为至尊主他是因为主 Krishna 是至尊的力量。如果他想停止时间的话，他可以停止时间。
Everything is under the control of Krishna.
一切都在主 Krishna 的控制之下。
Yeah, it's a little strange here in the Bhagavatam. It's a little, I said in the Bhagavad Gita, Krishna said he is time. But here in the Bhagavatam, the demigods are offering prayers that time is afraid of Krishna.
在这里是有一点点奇怪，因为在国家梵歌中我们听到的是主 Krishna 说他本人就是时间，但是这里的半神的供奉的祷文中说 时间的这个化身害怕主 Krishna。
Okay.
This question from Xi Yang Yang, 顶拜姑的莲花读感恩翻译，读经典的梵文诗节是否比读中文净化力更大？ Basis to Guru's Lotus Feet, whether if we read the sutras Sanskrit, whether it's better than we read the Chinese?
Well, it's not important what you read, but what is important is that you understand it.
这个不是说，重点不是说你读的是什么，重点在于你理解的这个程度。
So if you read the Sanskrit and don't understand it, I don't think you get much benefit.
如果你读的是梵文诗，但是你并不理解它的话，我不认为它能够给你带来更大的益处。
Just like when we sing the songs, we may sing Bengali songs. Prabhupada said, you can sing the songs, but if you don't know the meaning, you won't get any benefit.
就像我们如果也去学习孟加拉的这些歌曲，圣帕帕的说，我们即便能够唱诵这些孟加拉的祈祷文，这些祷文，但是如果我们不能知道它的益处的话，这个用益处不大。
Okay.
Next question.
Yeah.
Okay. Next question from Radha Priya Mataji. 顶拜姑的莲花族感谢翻译主持和所有奉献者。天地Indra是半神人，也是奉献者。他给予仁慈和分摊罪恶是功利性活动吗？这和奉献者的仁慈和诅咒有什么不同呢？ Obeisance to Guru's lotus feet. And I want to ask, Indra is the demigod and also the devotee. He give the benediction and show the simple reaction. Does these things is karma activities?
Yeah.This is karma. This is a karmic activity. Yeah.
这个是功利性活动。So, these karma activities, what's the difference between Indra's doing and the devotees doing, giving the mercy and the curse?
Devotees giving mercy and curse?
Yeah. Indra's activities between the devotees.Giving the mercy or curse.
Which devotees?
Devotees usually like to give the mercy, or he want to curse someone. So, what is the difference between the devotees this kind of activities and the Indra's sharing the simple reactions and give the benedictions?
Well, a devotee gives mercy, and a devotee, when he gives mercy, then he brings them to Krishna consciousness. You see, this is the difference, that this Indra is not always acting like a pure devotee. He's not always acting in devotional service. He acts for his own sake.
Indra 的这个活动，他并不总是在奉爱服务的路途上，他做的一些，他现在所做的这些活动是为了他自己的原因。
He doesn't act for the interests of Krishna.
他做的不是为了能够获得 Krishna 的兴趣。
But he's thinking about he's thinking more about maintaining the order in the universe.And he wants to make sure the demigods have control of the heavenly planets.
他总是想让这个宇宙保持着一种秩序，能够让半神人控制着这个天堂星球。
But the pure devotees, they give mercy, they will give mercy, and they may curse. It will all be for the benefit of that person to bring them to Krishna consciousness.
但是一位奉献者，一位纯粹奉献者，他给予仁慈或者说诅咒，他是为了能够让对方能够来到 Krishna 知觉，或者说能够在 Krishna 知觉获得一些益处。
Indra is just concerned about his own situation.
但是 Indra 想的是他自己的处境。
In relation to his duty also, he has a duty as the king of heaven. He has to maintain the order in the universe.
Indra 是天地的，就是说天堂的这个国王，他希望这个一切都在秩序之中。
So he's doing that service on behalf of the Supreme Lord.
他为了至尊主而做这个服务。
But the pure devotees, they're thinking more about delivering the souls back to Godhead.
纯粹奉献者他想的更多的是如何把灵魂带回守神。
Indra is just thinking about maintaining a nice situation here in the material world.
但是 Indra 想的是如何能够维持在物质世界的各种各样的处境。
But the devotees are thinking how to get the soul back to Godhead.
奉献者想的是如何能够让这个灵魂回归守神。
So that's the difference.
这个是不同的。
Some people want to stay here and be happy and be comfortable. But the pure
有一些人他想待在这里，他想变得快乐，他想变得舒适。
But the pure devotees want to go back to Godhead.
但是一个纯粹奉献者，他想回归守神。Question from Vaishnava Vaishnavivani Mataji. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. It's very interesting to know how women and the people in the desert is sharing the simple reaction of the Lord Indra. No ways many people, nowadays many people go to desert areas like the Dubai to earn money. So is it advisable not to go and live in the desert area unless for preaching? My doubt is why. Vishwarupas, one of the head, become a sepulcher. I was wondering if the indicate is the origin of all sorrows we see around us. Sorry for two questions at one time.
Sparrows.
Sparrow.
Yeah, sparrow. We have a lot of sparrows here in Mayapur.
Okay, 麻雀, 麻雀. Hare Krishna Guru Maharaj. 这个非常有趣的一点是我知道了，今天我知道了女人，然后还有人们他们生活在沙漠地区，都是在承担着这个罪恶反应，都是在承担着Indra的罪恶反应。现在很多人都去到沙漠地区，比如说迪拜去挣钱，是不是说不建议去到那个地方，像沙漠地方的这样的地方去生活，除非是为了传教的话，就不建议人们去到沙漠地方的这样的地方去生活呢？我的疑问是，为什么 Vishwarupa 的一个头变成了一个麻雀？我也非常好奇，是不是意味着它是一种原始的麻雀？它是原始的一种麻雀，这就是我的两个问题。Hare Krishna。
Yes, People go to the Dubai to make money, they go to the desert areas. It's not a very auspicious place, not auspicious place. You can't perform ritualistic ceremonies there, but you can perform Harinam Sankirtan there. You can do Sankirtan. Sankirtan is transcendental. You see, a material situation, you can't go there to the desert to perform ritualistic ceremonies, but that's for material activities. But for transcendental activities, you can go anywhere.
确实去到迪拜的这个地方不利于如果从物质的角度来讲是不利于的因为那里无法做这种伟大的祭祀的仪式但是呢在那里可以做 Hare Krishna Sankirtan 就是齐颂圣名的这种祭祀如果从物质的角度我们是不去这种地方是并不很吉祥的但是如果我们在那里能够唱诵 Hare Krishna 就确实一种很超然的活动。
And I don't know the reason why one of the heads of Vishwaroop became a sparrow. I have no idea.
我也不知道，就是关于第二个问题，我也不知道为什么 Vishwaroopa 的头变成了一个麻雀。 Now, question for Yuna Mataji. Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, please accept my humble obeisances. All glory to Srila Prabhupada. If our work is not suitable for devotees, such as selling cigarette or alcohol, can we offer its fruits to Krishna? Hare Krishna, Guru Maharaj, 如果我们的工作并不适合一个奉行者，比如说像卖香烟或者酒。 我们是否能够把这个结果也供奉给Krishna呢? Hare Krishna.
Yes, you can.
它是可以的。
Definitely. Whatever you're earning, you can use it to offer to Krishna.
无论你很必然的是可以的，无论你就是说挣来的这个钱是怎样，你都可以去供奉给Krishna。
But Krishna will be more pleased if you can make the money without selling beer and cigarettes.
但是 Krishna 会更开心，如果你挣的这个钱不是通过卖香烟和卖酒而得来的， Krishna 会更开心。 Next question from Rasarati Mataji. 请顶顶拜亲爱的Gurudev，半神的知觉应该是很高的，为什么还做这些罪恶的事情？或者说这一切都是至尊主的意愿吗？那上演这些逍遥时光又是说明了什么？感谢亲爱的Gurudev. Obeisances to dear Gurudev. Ordinary the demigod, the consciousness of the demigod should be very high. Why they do these sinful things?
Well, you have to understand demigods are not pure devotees and they're attached to their service, they're attached to their material position.
你要了解的是，半神人他并不是纯粹奉献者，他们非常依附于他们的位置以及他们的服务。
They want to keep their position in heaven and they want to keep that opulence of the heavenly planets.
他们想保持他们在半神的天堂的这个位置，他们也想保持他们天堂的富裕。So
that's why these things happen.
所以这就是为什么这些事情发生。 Does this all things is the Lord Lord intense Lord's winning the winning of the Lord?
The what?
The first he asked why the demigod do these things. Second she asked everything happened is all the winning of the Lord?
Arrangement of the Lord?
Yes, oh yes, yes.
The will of the Lord?
The willing.
The willing.
Will, yes.
Willing.
Yeah. Yeah, willing.
The, simply you could say the desire of the Lord.
Yeah, okay, okay, the desire of the Lord. Sorry.
Well, not exactly the desire of the Lord, but Krishna, it was the desire of Indra. Krishna is the overseer and the permitter.
我们不能这么确切地说是 Krishna 是一切的观察者和准许者。
So Krishna allows the living entities their independence. You cannot say it's all Krishna's doing, but Krishna facilitates the desire of the living entity.
我们不能说是Krishna的意愿要这么做, 而是这些个体生物想要这么做, Krishna, 满足他的意愿。
So the living entities, they desire to do something, and then Krishna sanctions it, and then he arranges to facilitate it through the material nature.
个体生物有这个愿望, Krishna 准许, 然后便安排了物质自然的这些设施, 去让事情发生。
So it's not Krishna's, it wasn't Krishna doing, you can't say Krishna was responsible for doing it, it was the desire of the individual living entity.
我们说这不是主Krishna所做的，也不是主Krishna回应，而是个体生物要做这个事情。
Okay.
Okay, and the third, she asked, what this pastime teaches us.
Well, this pastime teaches us, you've not heard the whole pastime, you have to wait till you hear the whole pastime.
我们这个逍遥时光还没有完全的结束, 所以我们得等到这个逍遥时光结束之后。
But we'll hear how the demon Vritasura is actually a great devotee, and he took birth as a demon just to finish his karma so he could go back to Godhead.
这个逍遥时光还没有结束，Vritasura其实上是一个恶魔，但是实际上他是一个伟大的奉献者。他投生为这个恶魔的躯体，只是为了结束他的恶业报。
So Vritasura in his previous life he was a devotee.
Vritasura在他的前一世是一个伟大的奉献者。
And he was cursed.
但是受到了诅咒。
But that cursing was an arrangement for him to go back to Godhead.
但是这个诅咒就是一种特殊的安排，让他能够回归守神。
So we learn from this pastime that demons, although someone may be in the body of a demon, he can be a great devotee.
我们从这个故事中了解到，一个人他即便是恶魔，他有可能也是一个奉献者。
You cannot judge a person's spiritual position by the material body.
我们无法通过一个人的物质躯体去判断他的灵性地位。
That's one of the lessons.
这是我们能够从中了解明白到的一点。
Okay.
Okay. Next question from Hari Vamsa. 怎么去帮助一个患抑郁症的奉献者？如果对方有轻生的想法，作为奉献者，怎么去帮助这位奉献者？ How to help a devotee who have a very strong depression, suffers from depression? If these devotees have some idea of want to kill himself, so how to help these kind of devotees?
Well, we have to get them to chant, and we have to get them to read the scriptures.
我们得让这样的奉献者去唱诵，去学习经典。
They have to learn the nature of the soul, that the soul is eternal.
要让这个奉献者学理解啊，灵魂是永恒的。
And that suicide is not the solution to the problem.
自杀不是能够解决问题的方法。
We have to teach people.The solution to the problem is in devotional service. If we take shelter of Krishna,
我们得教帮助人们知道解决问题的方法是对为 Krishna 做奉爱服务。
We have to do proper chanting and hearing.
需要做一些恰当的聆听和唱诵。
Yeah.
Okay. Question all finished.
Okay.
Okay.
Vaman Ganshiya Subhudirai Ki Vaman Jantai Dufani Vaman Ganshiya Sati Mati Ji Chujar Raj Krishna Kumari Zainabin Yilman Vaman Ganshiya Soya Dufunction Sa Ling Ting Vaman Jufuniman Chang Song Khwaila Wanshut Ru Yi Shagasin Chi Jian Hare Krishna.Srila Prabhupada Ki
Jai
Jai 感谢 Guru Maharaj 的精彩讲课感谢